and I'm very pleased that you are willing to step forward. You have amazing experience. I've seen it in the National Security Council when you worked for Condi Rice. Certainly members of this committee appreciate the fact that you were staff director of this committee, as well as your experience on the House side. And it's not just about experience, it's about judgment. And so I've seen that, Steve, and I'm glad you're willing to step forward. As has been indicated today by my two colleagues who've already spoken, it's an important job at an important time. And your passion for the 76,000 people who represent all of us at the State Department is also commendable, and I appreciate that part of your testimony this morning. By the way, no notes, because it's a matter of you feeling this in your heart. I know that from our conversations. And I think that's needed right now at the State Department, frankly. I think morale is an issue, and I think your approach will be refreshing for a lot of people. So I'm glad you're stepping forward to do this. Few quick questions. One on China. As I mentioned to you briefly this morning, the Permanent Subcommittee Investigations yesterday issued a report. We had a hearing on China stealing intellectual property and specifically how they do it through their talent recruitment programs. Shocking. State Department testified. It was because visas are provided for a lot of these individuals who then become on contract with the Chinese government. The Chinese Communist Party actually controls this process. And then they are asked not to tell U.S.-funded entities, say National Science Foundation, NIH, Department of Energy, that they are, in effect, working for a Chinese institution, not allowed to disclose that, and they are required, in many cases, as you know, to bring information, research, back to China. Do you agree that we need to tighten this up, and specifically, will you work with us to ensure that the visa part of this is part of the approach that we take? The screening on the visas is virtually non-existent now in terms of individuals who we know are members of these talent recruitment programs. Can you speak to that?
Yes, thank you, Senator. In regard to the general issue you raise, absolutely it's a very serious issue for us, and it manifests itself in a number of ways, not just in these visits, but also it manifests itself in acquisitions of key industries and key parts of supply chains around the world, not just in the United States, incidentally, although obviously our concern is principally the United States, but it happens in the countries of many of our friends and allies around the world as well. And we're not the only ones who have woken up to it. We've seen a backlash in countries like Australia and Germany, and the European Union itself is pushing in a similar direction that many here in the United States Congress are pushing. I think it's very important for us to find a way to work with like-minded countries in reversing this, because it is a global problem, and because a lot of times those technologies may be made in America, but they're found all over the world, and likewise, many technologies from other parts of the world make their way here into our industries and into our economy and into our military-industrial complex.
I think that's insightful, and in fact, we're working with some of those other countries because, in fact, we do provide, as we do here in America, because we're transparent in terms of our research. We have the right ethical standards, I believe.
In regard to the visas, I'll take a look at it, Senator. I'm not sufficiently in depth on issues of how we change consular processes and how we would do that, but it's certainly something we'll be willing to take a look at.
Great. I would tell you, your representative yesterday actually seemed to be asking us to help them with legislation to be able to tighten up some of the visa requirements. North Korea. As you know, I represent Ohio and close to the Warm Beer family, and appreciate your work there, but it has exposed this human rights disaster in North Korea to so many Americans. And through Otto Warm Beer's death, I think there's been more awareness. You're now taking a new role, not just with regard to negotiating with North Korea, but a broader role as Deputy Secretary. Are you willing to help us to be able to expose the human rights violations that occur on a daily basis in North Korea, and will you help this committee in particular to come up with the right approach?
Sure. Senator, as I said in my opening statement, core values of the United States of America that I will advance in all of my work, including in that portfolio. I will say that, like all of you, I am deeply moved by what happened to the Warm Beer son. It is unacceptable, and part of the hypothesis of our engagement with North Korea on a broad set of issues, including denuclearization, but others as well, is to create a better basis for us to be able to have discussions on some of these issues that have previously been off the table in our discussions. We're not there yet, not by a long shot, but I assure you that not only will I give attention to these issues, but I will give attention to Fred and Cindy Warmbier as well.
My time has expired, but I just want to mention one other issue quickly. Global Engagement Center, you and I have talked about it quite a bit. Senator Murphy's here, he may talk about it as well. We've had a tough time in the past sometimes getting State Department focus. Recently, it's been good. Mm-hmm. You made a commitment to me already in private. If you could make a commitment here publicly that you are supportive of the Global Engagement Center and going after disinformation and propaganda of our adversaries, especially Russia.
Yeah, absolutely, Senator. The Global Engagement Center, which was an excellent idea but a little bit slow getting off the ground, is now up and running. As I mentioned to you earlier, I had a chance to sit down with the director of the center, Leah Gabriel. She's incredibly talented. She's put together a strong team. She's even more importantly, she's got an office space inside the Department of State for that team, which is like getting blood out of a turnip. And she has also managed to get a substantial amount of funding, including support from some of the other departments, including the Defense Department, to get up and running. And she is up and running, and she is doing some great work. Her and her team are in the process already of refuting some of the false narratives that we had no tools available to us to refute 4 years ago.
Thank you.